Good morning, Regis. And beautiful Catty Bree. You can't go out with us, though. Meow. Sit. You know the drill, and I'll sit. Stay. Alright, come on. Bye, guys. We'll be back. And there's another one of mine. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Walk with Regis. Today is September 18th. The weather will be high 70s. Maybe 77, 78. No percentage of rain. It'll be a little chillier than yesterday, but it's starting to cool off. But for now, it's a welcome change. And just wait till everybody changes their stories when the temperatures reach 20 degrees. I'm gonna have to have some warm clothes by then. Good boy. And in today's news, there was nothing. I couldn't find anything. I spent about 10 minutes on the couch scrolling through the news. Come on. I couldn't find anything in the news. I mean, I found something about a motorcyclist in Batavia seriously injured after a crash. And something in a New York City apartment where a woman, a tenant doing a welfare check on a woman, found her dead with another woman in the apartment living with the decaying corpse. That was in New York City. But again, they're not Buffalo. And I really only want to try to report Buffalo stories. Kind of unusual that I didn't see anything for Buffalo. Work went pretty good yesterday. I think I finally have the hang of my job. I make only maybe one mistake a day, if that. There's been quite a few days where I don't make any mistakes at all. And I'm starting to have a little more fun. Yep. Me, fun at work. Though, of course, now there's this new girl who just completely outshines me, and I'll probably go back to being my withdrawn introverted self. When I'm telling you this lady, whew. I mean, it's a good thing that she is always making everybody laugh, but she seems to, like, draw all the attention to herself by making goofy dances and going up to them and making jokes and... Nah, let her have it. If she wants the spotlight, she can have it.
Oh, look, guys.
That's a mosquito hawk. Good thing I didn't step on it. I would have felt bad. I probably wouldn't have known, but if I had known, if I hadn't seen it, I would have felt bad. The other day at work, funny story, true story. This bee was buzzing around a customer. So I finished scanning them, went over, and managed to gently scoop the bee out of the air into my sleeve. And I coaxed it onto my hand. Well, I scared the living crap out of everybody by having the bee crawl around on my hand. I'm sitting there talking to it like, who's a pretty little bee? Who's a, you're not gonna hurt anyone, are you? Oh, poor misunderstood creature. And they're just standing there in shock and amazement. And I just said before that to my managers that bees never stung me, that they let me pick them up and handle them, which is true. I've got plenty of videos of this. And they'll let me pet them and everything. So I walked the bee over to the managers and I said, you guys didn't believe me, did you? Because I had a feeling they didn't. Most people don't. And then when I showed them the bee on my hand, they were like, oh, hell no. And they all scattered away from me, my hand, and the bee. It's kind of funny. So then I took the bee outside and put it in a safe spot, and I wished it well. Cute little yellow jacket. Nope, didn't get stung. I think it licked me once. Then I came back in, and the three customers after the person I checked out, that's all they could talk about. Did you really have a bee on your hand? Then they're talking about how they get stung no matter what, even if they're just sitting there minding their own business. It feels like the bees are going out of their way stinging them, and I'm thinking to myself, what makes me so different? I mean, I know I used to rescue a lot of bees out of swimming pools when I was little. I used to just scoop up the poor drowning little bees in out of the water and let them dry on my hand, and they would lick me all the time. But I mean, what did they do? Mark me as friend or something? That was years ago. I mean, I shouldn't have that scent still on me. Anyway, it's baffling. I never get stung, and I'm still not sure why I can pet any yellow jacket. Alright guys, that's the end of this video. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you don't, hit the dislike button. It don't bother me any. Share if you want to. Subscribe if you want to. Everything here is optional. And we will see you guys tomorrow. Bye!